Okay, the spring show, it goes back a long time. We've been doing this for 25 years, but the show itself, I think we had spring concerts for a while, and they were just like another concert. They were like classical things and our kind of festival type stuff. But at one point, I think when Matt showed up in 98, we started to do more fun music, do a little more of a pop kind of a thing. And sometimes we thought about doing a theme, and pretty soon we changed the name to the Spring Show sometime in the decade of the 2000s. And each show had its own flavor, its own sort of theme. And at some point we started adding kids' solos in.
Like this huge giant production. We've got anywhere from 10 to 15 choir numbers, and we also have 15 or so solos. So we have an intermission now because it's about a 2.5 hour, you know, sort of ordeal. But when I first got here, it was just short of spectacular, I would say. We had to do the concerts in a church or in some other facility where the acoustics weren't great. But we did the same kind of format. We would have some solos, but not to the extent we have now.
When we got to the Sheboygan Hall, we had a big stage. It was a really nice venue. And we started filming things, and my son was doing the filming for that, and my other son would do the graphic work, and we would have stuff on the screen. We had really great looking posters and flyers, and as a matter of fact, my son would make a video, promo video, and it's just got to be a bigger production over the years. And so now we're at a point where it's just a given that we're going to do lots of audio, video, and it's a high level of performance with the kids, both whether they're solos or whether they're in the choir.
The first year I was here at Buchanan, we did a Disco Divas medley with the Women's Chorale, and there was only about 20, 25 girls in that choir, and they could sing the tune really good, and they could dance it really good, but they couldn't sing and dance it really good. So Roger and I had this great idea to have me dress up in like a 70s tan leisure disco suit sort of thing and do all the choreography more or less to kind of distract the audience from watching the choir. You know, listen to the choir but watch Mr. Dean. That was kind of like the most memorable embarrassment of my career.
Probably the most memorable thing we've done in spring shows would have to be in 2010, and it was the show that happened almost a year after Michael Jackson passed away. And I got the idea in the summer, I don't know why, I was at Lake Tahoe, and I thought, you know, we ought to do Thriller. And so we did. We taught the kids how to do the Thriller dance. And so it was really one of the first things in a show that we did that didn't have singing. We didn't sing anything. Michael Jackson's track played, but all the kids learned the Thriller dance. And so they were on the stage. Some of them were in costumes that looked like zombies. And we did lighting and the whole bit. And I think that was the first show that we actually sold out. We had 750 people in the audience, and because they just wanted to see the kids do Thriller. And so we did, you know, our other stuff too, but that was the thing that everybody came out to see. It was way cool. We've done Disney, we've done Broadway, we've done A Blast from the Past, you know, music that just pretty much anything that happened before now, which was pretty open-ended. All kinds of things. And so I pick music then for the choirs is wrapped around those themes. And then we let the kids pick songs that they want to audition on as soloists, ensembles. And we have a big audition for that. And we take, you know, so many kids because it's a pretty big show. We end up having with an intermission, it'll go probably over 2 hours. And so we mix it up between the choirs coming out and singing a song and then a couple of solos and things. And we usually get a pretty nice thematic show as a result. when I retire and somebody else takes this job, I think the idea of a spring show will continue on. It may change the form a little bit, but Matt Dean's planning to stay on, and I know he'll want to have some influence in that whole idea of doing something like that to continue.
I want to try to continue the same format, and whoever takes Roger's place, hopefully they'll buy into the big production so we can kind of keep the same thing. We probably will tweak a few things. All in all, my level, my standard that I want for the choirs is the same. So I'm hoping to have that influence to keep the high level and the entertainment.
You know, I've talked to alumni over the years, and every one of them that talks to me always has some memorable thing, like a concert, the one song, and it could have been a spring show thing. It might have been something else, and a festival that we did. And I know for me, when I was in high school, I still have fond memories of those moments, those times. It just doesn't, you never lose those. And so I'm just really happy to have given students an opportunity to maybe have those moments. You know, you go on with life, you get married, you have kids, you know, and you don't stay in high school, but you still remember those good times, and it's always kind of a fun thing.
Without their hard work that they put in years ago, 25 years ago, we wouldn't be where we are today. It's because of their hard work that our shows and our choir and the level of ability and everything has been able to evolve to where it is. What it is now is because of the 25 years worth of students and people who have sung in this choir and poured their hearts into the music and bought into the Bergman and Dean, you know, circus.
And I'm hoping that when we have this reunion concert, that there'll be a little bit of reliving of some of those memories. Obviously you can't do it the way we did it, but it's always fun to reminisce about stuff like that. So I'm glad I could be a part of that.
We've just always wanted to push them to their best, and we usually got that, and that's why we're doing this show, and we really want to pay tribute in this show to them to say thank you for being a part of the legacy.